Dr. Doreswamy Iyengar, representing the traditional style of Veena played in Mysore, South India, has been honored by the President of India with the title Padma Bhushana and by the Mysore University with a doctorate for his contribution to rendition and scholarly exposition of the Veena. Dr. Iyengar presents the pure classical music and does not use any mechanical devices on his instrument. There are quite a few varieties of Veenas, but the two forms which are popular in South India are the Saraswati Veena and the Vichitra Veena, or Gotavadyam as it's popularly known. The Veena presented today is the Saraswati Veena, which has its reference to the Vedic period. But the form that it has acquired now was evolved over many centuries and was brought to use by a ruler of Tanjavur in South India called Raghunath Nayak and his Prime Minister, Govinda Dikshidhar. It was Govinda Dikshidhar who first constructed a Veena with fixed frets. Otherwise, like in the sitar, the frets were adjusted to the different microtones used in any particular scale. The frets are fixed onto a resinous wax, and there are 24 frets, like a piano has keys. The Veena has a range of 3.5 octaves. The Veena has 7 strings, 4 on the top and 3 on the side towards the player. The side strings act as drone and also are plucked for rhythm. The tuning of the Veena is simple. The first string towards the player is the fundamental string in Indian music, the Sa or Si of the middle octave. The second string is the fifth, Pa or G, lower octave. And the third string again, the Sa of lower octave. Fourth, the Pa, still lower. The side strings are tuned the other way round. The first one is the same as the top first one, the Sa. Then the second Pa of the middle octave. The last one again, the Sa of higher octave. One can do the modal shift by changing the middle side string to the note the player wishes to. There are three different fingering techniques for playing the Veena: the Tanjore style, the Mysore style, and the Bezawada or Andhra style. The artist today will be playing in the Mysore style. Starting exercises in the Raga Maya Malava Gaula, established by Sri Purandradasa about the 15th century. Now, first of the three graded exercises, Sarale Varse, first speed, second speed, and third speed. These exercises are taught in a basic rhythm or tala of 8 beats to a cycle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, emphasis falling on 1, 5, and 7. Janti Varase, also a basic exercise with 2 notes attached together. ¶¶ the subject, it should be mentioned here that there are basic 7 different varieties of talas, alankaras. Now, alankaras in the different varieties of talas. To Gita or Geetam. The term Gita literally means a song. In music, it has established itself as a particular melodic format, but the raga character in which the particular Geetam is set is brought out. The rhythm is also simple. The swarajati or jatiswaram. These Sanskrit words mean grouping the notes. These are mainly passages of musical notes set in different ragas and talas. These pieces are used by Indian classical dancers, especially from Bharatanatyam school. Some swarajatis have words to their melody. Then they are called jatiswarams. A lot of emphasis is placed on the grouping of the notes and the tala in every set piece. Varnams are scholarly compositions. They are very technical, and at the same time, they will have the character of the ragas they are set in. They are good exercise for rhythmic formations. The lyrics or sahitya are short with more vowels. This enables the singer to train his or her voice, and an instrumentalist the fingering technique. Varnam has four parts: Pallavi, Anupallavi, Chitteswara, then comes the Charana and Solfa passages. The Pallavi, Anupallavi and Charana have words or Sahitya. There are literally hundreds of Varnas in many ragas and different thalas. A musician practices these Varnams every day, even after achieving proficiency. In the South Indian concert tradition, most artists start their concert with a Varnam. Artists get ideas and improvise on the raga and the solfa passages by practicing these Varnams. Next, we have the Kriti or Kirtana. It's an evolved music form. Every musical composer of some repute over the last two centuries has attempted to compose Kritis. The Sahitya or lyrics are generally devotional, in praise of a god. In this musical form, there's ample scope to improvise on the raga that the Kriti is set in, then improvisation at one particular point, first using the lyrics, which is called Niraval, and then the improvisation of solfa passages called the Swara Kalpana, still keeping within the rhythmic cycle or the tala the Kriti is set. They are short and crisp forms, principally a dance form, brisk and attractive music. These days, musicians sing or play these formats at the end of a concert. After playing a long raga alapana improvisation in solfa passages, which generally start with a slow tempo and build up, the audience need to concentrate to enjoy the music. A tilana will suddenly change the atmosphere to a lighter vein. Thank you. The artist will take one Melakarta raga, raga Karaharapriya, similar to the Western Dorian mode, and he will demonstrate the various derivatives from the one major raga. Derivatives are formed by dropping one or two notes from the major scale. First, a few permutations of pentatonic scales in raga Abhogi. Now, a few with six notes, Raga Sri Ranjani. He will mix the five and six notes in Raga Jayamanohari. Next, five notes one way, either ascending or descending, and all the seven original notes of that particular scale in the descending, in Raga Shalaga Bhairavi. He will now play the notes in a zigzag manner, Vakra Raga, Palamanjari. When these details are worked out, it was realized that each of the 72 main ragas could have innumerable derivatives. Dr. Doreswamy Iyengar will now play a tilana in Raga Kapi, set to a rhythmic cycle of seven beats of three and four. First, there will be an introduction or alapana. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.